Fort Lapin, Snowlapin. Welcome to another edition of Bands, Bikes and Booze Reviews. I've got one here from Belgian beer heaven, that is Bruges, and it is the Fort Lapin Snowlapin, which is their Christmas beer. Now, I've been to Bruges quite a few times, and we actually done a bike tour there recently, and I never got the chance to go and visit the brewery, but next time, when all this COVID bollocks is over, I will definitely be going over there and checking this lot out, because I've tried two of their beers and they have been absolutely outstanding. They've been going since 2011, and their beers, in my opinion, are really, really good. Now, Belgium, of course, has quite a big brewing heritage. But this lot have come along, they've been going since 2011, and they have done some absolutely cracking beers. If you look on the channel, you'll see the reviews of the beers I've tried from the Fort Lapin, and that's one of the reasons why I wanted to get their Christmas beer. I don't know, I'm not sure whether you know, but it's December, so I am going through all the Christmas beers at the moment, and I'm doing the German stuff, I'm doing the Belgian stuff, and I'm doing the British stuff that I can get hold of. And this is one of the ones that I really wanted to try out, because I'd seen it advertised way back, and I did make a mental note of saying I really want to try their Christmas beer, because I've tried their, I think it's the double and the triple, and it was really good. And the Christmas beer is usually where they pull out all the stops, certainly in Germany. I'm not sure about Belgium. From what I've tried so far though, it seems to be the trend that they really do pull out all the stops. And they do the same over here in the United Kingdom, because I've tried the Sam Smith stuff and the Shepherd Neame stuff as well, and it's been really good. So it would appear that all the breweries do really sort of pull out all the stops to do a really decent Christmas beer, because there's people that buy beers only at certain times of the year, you know, summer maybe, and Christmas definitely. You know, I know people that don't drink all year round and just drink at Christmas, and they end up making absolute arses of themselves and throwing up and wondering, oh, I'm never drinking again, wondering why they don't like the taste of beer. You're not meant to like the taste of beer. It's the end result that counts. Anyway, it's not really, believe me, it's not really. But the Fort Lapin stuff, it's good. I've tried some of their stuff in the past, as I said, and it's been really good. So this promises to be a good one. So without further ado, I just want to get this beer investigated and tasted. Right, this is a Christmas beer. It is a 330ml bottle. It's 9%. Now, I've just tried a Belgian Christmas beer that was 10%. That was really good. It was from the Verheuge Brewery. I think that's how it's pronounced. Verheuge Brewery. That was 10%. It was really nice. Really good Christmas beer. It was a blonde, 10%, but you wouldn't know it. There was no trace of ethanol in there at all. This is the Fort Lapin, or Lapin. I'm not quite sure on the pronunciation of it, but it's named after a Belgian fortress that was based in Bruges. I'm not sure how that fared, but they've opened up a brewery in honour of that. And this is the Christmas beer. As I say, it's a 330ml bottle. It is 9%. No information available on the website about what's in the beer. I don't look up beer reviews, because I really want to make my own decision on beers. I don't want to be influenced by what other people are, you know, perceiving before I actually try it. So I must admit, I've been caught on the hop here a little bit, because I don't know what style of beer it is. I don't know what's in the beer, because there's nothing on the website. I will only check the website and there's not much information. In fact, I don't even think this is listed on there. I think it's listed, but there's no brew sheet or anything like that. In fact, the Full Lapin website is pretty poor, to be honest. But this is what it is, and that's all you need to know. Right, let's get this open and see what's going on. Cap is just plain red, nothing on there at all. It's as red as an Irishman's nose.
Ireland is like a plum pudding. It's brown and damp and only comes to life when you cover it in alcohol and set fire to it.
Let's get it in the glass. Really not sure what sort of what style of glass it's supposed to be drunk out of, but I think a tulip glass is as good as any. It's quite a dark beer, actually. 9% dark beer, so it could effectively be a quad. Let's see what we're getting on the nose. I have to say, it looks really nice. Typically Belgian as well. Whoa. Spicy. That really does smell good. Wow. There's a backbone of caramel malt with just a ton of spices on top of that. I'm getting ginger, grassy herbal notes out of that. Now, I'm actually getting sort of hashish. If you've ever smoked hashish, I'm getting little aromas of that from what I can perceive anyway. Like an earthy hashish style aroma. I know there's no fucking hashish in this, but that's what I'm getting. And there's like a smokiness to it as well. It really does smell interesting. And it's a dark beer, which is unusual because the ones I've tried so far have all been quite light in colour. I tried the Greif Bock from Germany, which was almost like a Helles, a very strong Helles. Again, no perceivable ethanol in there. I've just tried the Beardy Noel. I can't remember the name of it. It was only 10 minutes ago. That's how fucking useless I am. But that was really nice. It was a blonde, 10% blonde. You would not know that at all. Very sweet. This smells really good. And you know what? It's even smelling like a bit like a porter, where it's got, you know, like caramel, toffee malt. It's definitely got roasted malt in there, and that roasted malt is quite big. It smells really good. It really does. There's a mixture of roasted malt and spices. You know, a typical winter beer, and it's fucking freezing out there. I don't know what the temperature is, but it's raining and it's cold and it's miserable. This smells really good. If it tastes as good as it smells, this is going to be an absolute cracker. Cheers. Oh. Wow, that is complex. I do remember there's a subscriber on this channel called Mark, and his missus tried a stout, and I remember her exact words were, it tasted like an old ashtray. No, it tasted like an ashtray and an old museum. I'm definitely getting the old ashtray in here. When I said it tasted like a porter, a really good porter or stout, you do get what I perceive to be cigarette ash in there. It sounds disgusting, but mixed with all the other sweet flavours, you know, it does work, believe me. Oh, wow. There's like a ginger, a nutmeg in this that's quite strong, and it leaves a dry, almost bitter finish on this. There's big caramel and toffee malt initially, but the spice on the end, it's typical what I call Christmas or Yuletide spice. If there's one thing I can say, it's this is definitely not lacking in character. There is a ton of complex flavours in this. God. There's like a coffee notes underlining that, but on top of that there is like ginger, nutmeg, herbal notes on top of that, and there's a subtle sweetness to it as well. So there is a bit of candy sugar to that too, but I'll tell you something, it's really nice, and it's definitely one for sipping. Now, I know that, you know, certain Belgian beers are very strong in the flavour stakes and you have to take them very seriously. You can't just neck them and think they're like session beers. But this really is one of them beers that you need to just stop and take note of every mouthful, because you really are getting different flavours in each mouthful. It's really nice. That is really nice. Do you know what? Thought Lapin are really good at what they do. And they've got this on the website as being discontinued, which is a real shame. I really hope that it's not. I'm sure they must have done, well, they obviously have done some for this year, and you'll be able to buy this online. But this is really worth checking out. Now, again, as I say, at 9%, you do get some of the ethanol in there. That's definitely there. But there is coffee in there and toffee malt, which is topped with a spicy sort of backbone on this. The big thing on this is spice. And it is like, as I say, them Christmas spices that you get on a Christmas cake. It's really nice, I have to say. There's a little bit of orange peel in there as well. But you know, with every mouthful, you're getting a different flavour. I'm really impressed with this. Wow, really good. So what's the verdict on Snowlapin, Snowlapin? Well, this brewery was already in high esteem, in my opinion, because I've tried two of their beers before and they were really good. This came from Beers of Europe, and I don't know what's going on with Beers of Europe and Snowlapin, but they tend to sell all their beers, and I'm glad they do because they're really good. Now, they've only been going since 2011, but I'll tell you something, that is brilliant. But what I really like about them is they haven't jumped on the, you know, the IPA craft beer bandwagon. They were founded in 2011 and they've just carried on keeping on that Belgian brewing tradition, you know, the blondes, the doubles and the triples. And this stuff, the Christmas beer, it really is, I have to say, so far, don't get me wrong, I've got a fridge full of Christmas beer there, and I've tried some German stuff, I've tried some of the Belgian Christmas beer. For me, so far, this is the best one. And it's one of them beers that you just don't want to neck. You want to sort of savour every mouthful, because there is different flavours in every mouthful. And I really like it. And do you know what? This, for me, is 10 out of 10. Just for the sheer complexity of the beer. It really is one of them beers that you need to savour every mouthful. And I do say this about these strong Belgian beers, you know, they're not for necking, they are for guzzling. You know, if the German Helles's and stuff like that are for, you know, necking back, you know, drinking steins of, the Belgian stuff is very much what they call the degustation beers, where you really need to, you know, take small mouthfuls and savour the flavour. Now, some people might say that's pretentious or poncy, but I don't give a fuck. It tastes nice and it ain't wine. So yeah, this is really good. This for me is 10 out of 10 all day long. If you can get this, so far for me, this is the best Christmas beer I've tasted from Belgium. Now, I've got a few in the fridge which may, you know, surpass this, but for me so far, this is a 10 out of 10. It really is that good. Recommended. And remember, beer is working class champagne.